People have to learn how to handle life. That's really why we have these meetings. The people say, you know, that if life didn't come in the way, I'd build the Amway business. You know, if life didn't come in the way, you don't need the Amway business. Okay? So here, why do we have these meetings? Why do we have CDs? It's to prepare you for life, because life is going to happen anyway. Okay? And success-minded people are prepared. See, when you're prepared, anything comes your way, you can still handle it. You know? I tell people a dream is like a baby. It's something that gets added onto your life, but you assign it a priority. You don't say, I'm too busy to handle a dream. If it's like your baby, it's like having one baby, and when the second one comes on, you don't say, look, I'm too busy, can I return this and get my money back? Because it's a priority in your life, you know? So it may not be a physical thing like a baby, but it's still a priority. So you have to handle that, and you have to put it, package it in such a way, like, for example, no matter what happens, people continue to live on life, you know? If somebody loses a dear one or something happens, they still have to pay their bills, they still have to go to work, you know? At a survival level, people know how to do it. But at a success level, when you're trying to exceed, you know, your lifestyle, it becomes more of a choice rather than a survival thing. But you have to bulletproof yourself, okay? And this all ties into what we call self-image. You know, the quality of one's life is always directly proportional to self-image. You know, if a person's self-image is high, they're going to have a higher quality of life. Okay? For example, if somebody is making, $30,000 a year, they can't suddenly start making $300,000 a year because, first of all, they don't know how to do it. Second thing is, even if they had the money, they wouldn't know how to handle it. That's why usually you hear about somebody winning the lottery, maybe $100 million, but you don't hear about them later on. They don't show up on the cover of Fortune magazine. Somehow they, I don't know what they do with the money, but you don't hear them, you know, multiplying that or giving, or typically you don't. There might be some exceptions, but typically you don't, okay? That's because their self-image is not there yet. In India, we have these little things called auto rickshaws. You might have seen it in a James Bond film. Okay, little three-wheelers. That's like a cab, you know. It'll take you to nooks and crannies that your Mercedes-Benz can't go into. You need that in India, you know, little areas that you can go to. And the way you start an auto rickshaw is you don't have a key for the ignition. You have a handlebar that they pull a couple of times, you know, and then it starts. If you take an auto rickshaw driver and you put him in a Mercedes-Benz on I-95 here, the first thing he'll do is pull the handbrakes up to start the car. Because he thinks that's how you start it, because that's where his thinking is. Okay? So we are all about increasing people's thinking and their self-image. You understand what I'm saying? So the BWW system is all about increasing self-image. You know those 9 core steps? Those are all about increasing self-image. You know, you look at this, the first step is that you show the plan, you know, 5 to 7 times a week to different people. Okay? All right, not to the same guy. Now, 5 to 7 times a week, when you do something consistently, it's like learning how to play basketball. See, you can never get good at anything unless you're kind of willing to go through the awkward phase. You know, I mean, if I want to learn how to play basketball, I have to be willing to sort of humiliate myself in public in the beginning, a little bit at least, right? Because I'm not going to be Jordan on the first day, right? It's going to be awkward. If I'm not willing to go through that phase, I really can't get good at it. But when I go through that phase, my self-image goes up. When you get good at something, your self-image goes up, right? The first time you do a three-pointer, your self-image goes up. But you're working towards it. So showing the plan is actually increasing your self-image, apart from, you know, the fact that you're getting people in, you know? When you use your own products, your self-image goes up. You start feeling good about yourself. I got excited about our brands. I liked the fact that I'd never heard of Glister when I got in. I liked it because it was my business. Another core step is that you do retail, 50 PV retail. What happens when you make a profit out of that? Your self-image goes up. You feel more confident, correct? How about reading every day? Reading from the recommended list of books. Every time you read, two things happen. First thing, positive information is going in, and during the same period, you're not watching television or doing something else that can be destructive. When positive stuff goes in the brain, what happens to your self-image? It goes up. Every single BWW core step is designed to. How about CDs? Incredible. My car is a university now. I don't get upset when the traffic is bad. I'm the only one laughing and smiling. It drives everybody else crazy around me. I'm putting good stuff in my brain. Increases my self-image. What happens when you when you're teachable? Teachable students, I'll tell you, when you become teachable, when you're in submission to your upline, you actually have the power. Bilbert calls it the power of submission. It's not slavery of submission. It's power of submission. Because if I go to my upline, if I tell Kanti, I'm submitting to you, you tell me, you have the freedom to correct me if I'm doing something wrong. And you tell me what to do, I'm going to do it. And if I'm going to do it, the burden is on him now. I have power over him. You understand what I'm saying? Because whatever he says, I'm going to do. And he's going to be careful about what he says. He's going to give me the... Because some people, you can tell them anything. Because they're not going to do it anyway. What do I do next? I just do back flips over the Four Seasons Hotel. Okay. All right. They're not going to do anything anyway. But you're looking for the people. When you are in submission to someone, guys, your self-image will go up. Because you're part of a team now. You get the edification. When somebody says good things about you, does your self-image go up? Your team's, entire team's self-image goes up. There is meaning behind it. A lot of thought that's gone behind this, guys. You know, when you when you're counseling with your upline, you know, and you draw your group out and you get an endorsement of what you're doing right, you're learning stuff, you're increasing your knowledge, it's all about self-image. So that's the thing that we got to realize, that this is about. So when you're building a balanced business, Dave talked about cupboard issues. Every so five or six deep, you pull people together. What do you do there? You build relationships, but you also have the tools. To what? To educate people so that, one, they can increase their self-image, then they can increase their knowledge about building the business. There are products there. There's product education going on, but there's also tools there. Okay? Because if I have a leg that's increasing in volume month after month, but I don't see anybody from that leg, I'm scared. Because they are not getting bulletproof, they're not getting educated about life, they're not preparing for a disaster or something that comes along in their life, and when it happens, that leg is gone, because they didn't prepare themselves. You understand what I'm saying? So it makes absolute perfect sense to get people to assist into the system. So I'm fanatical about getting people to meetings and the tools. You need to get excited about tools, you know. Typical Amway IBO getting into this business doesn't know about business ownership. There are many good things about business ownership, but there's one fact that a lot of people don't know, don't pay attention to, and that is that you get the opportunity to invest, and that's actually a privilege. This is a country of entrepreneurs, guys. This is a country that's made for entrepreneurs. I mean, they have no doubts about it. You know, they might be talking about China a lot, but this is the country that's about freedom. You know, who wants to be in a growing economy where you can't talk? You know, this is the place to be in, you know. So one thing about business, for example, people get excited. The employee-minded people gets excited about, person gets excited about being sent to a seminar by their company where the company pays for all the expenses. You know, and they might say, well, I'm for Brit Worldwide, I have to buy a ticket myself. They think of it as a negative. Actually, it's a positive. For the first time, you're taking part in the free enterprise system. You're actually able to invest. Because when the company pays for you, they're actually not paying for you. They're paying your money back, you know, because they figured it out when they figured your salary out, that they're going to spend this much on you. So it's already accounted. It's your money. Investing in your own business, in your own tools, is a privilege that only business owners have. In our business, business-minded people, when they come to a cover dish or a function, they're also, the first thing they look for is, what tools are you going to give me to build the business? They know there are products, but if you told them there are no tools, they won't be excited about the business.